What?
Who are you?
What?
Hello?
What?
Okay, anyway, hello everyone, welcome back to Jill's channel. So today, she thought she would show you a fun story she drew when she was in third grade to fourth grade. Let's get on with it. Whoosh. I'm sorry, Birdie.
So this is a story that I drew when I was in third grade to fourth grade. This story is called Mr. Banana's Trip. The idea is inspired by my teacher in second grade because at that time, we have many fun activities in class, which includes this toy called Mr. Banana. So I thought it would be nice to like draw a story using him. So basically, Mr. Banana's Trip is a story that is about Mr. Banana traveling around the world and writing letters to his friends. So it is inspired by a book I read when I was in kindergarten, and the book is called Monk. Wait, let me show you the book. So this is the book. It's called Monk, or how to pronounce it, I'm not really sure. So it's about this tiny teddy bear, which is
kind of like Brownie, but not quite.
So it's about this person, which is called Monk, and he travels around the world, like, for example, traveling to Lapland, traveling to Greece, traveling to Sahara Desert, and all these kind of places in the world. It's one of my favorite picture books when I was younger, and my dad used to read it to me, so I really recommend you read this. So I got the idea from Moog that he traveled to many different places. So yeah, thank you for this book for giving me this idea. Back to my Mr. Banana story. So of course, for drawing him traveling around the world, I have to draw a map of the world and all the places he's been in, because in the book Moog, he also drew a map. So yeah, I'm just gonna... It's not actually copying, but yeah, borrowing this idea, sorry. And so yeah, I came up with this map of Earth, and I just drew all the places Mr. Banana been in. So he's been in Australia, like as you can see here. He's been in Himalaya, Sahara, Amazon rainforest, Alaska, Pacific Ocean, and also even Mars, which is somewhere in the universe. So yeah, this is his travel map. Okay, let's start the story then.
Hi, I'm Mr. Banana. Although I'm a little banana, I love to travel to any places. Now let's see my great adventures to all of the places in our world. My full name, Mr. Betty Betty Bushy Goody Banana. So now let's get started to my first adventure. Yay! Are you excited? I am.
Okay, wait, I just noticed. So his first adventure, he traveled to Australia to surf, and he wrote a letter to his friend, Mr. Orange, since they're all fruits.
Dear Mr. Orange, hi. This is my first day of my great adventures. I decided to try something relaxing, something fun. I went to Australia. There I played surfing with a new friend coach named Uga. Funny name, huh? Anyway, I hope you do good.
Yeah, this is a very friendly banana. Moving on to the next location.
Dear Miss Grape, after 4 days in Australia, I went to a place you'll never imagine, Sahara Desert. Sahara Desert is really hot, burning even, but I managed to survive. Well, not exactly survive, but surely a crazy camel tries to eat me. I hope you have a good progress with your feather collection.
Yeah, so, this camel clearly sees a banana and wants to eat it.
Poor banana. Look, he's so scared. Poor banana. Aww.
Oh my god, from the hottest place in the world to the coldest.
Dear Red Apple, brr, so cold. I am at one of the coldest places of the world, near the South Pole, Alaska. luckily, Strawberry Jam found us a sauna, which is so warm and comfy. There's always snow here and many animals too. I made many new friends, and I would really like to meet Santa Claus.
Yeah, so this is the strawberry little miss here.
Oh, look, this is so funny. And he took off his peel and went naked in the bath.
Yeah, he's a banana, so he can do whatever he wants. Oh gosh, this is an epic scene.
Dear Goody Pie, can you possibly imagine a banana climbing the tallest mountain in the world, the Himalayas? Well, that's what I did. Believe me, that this day was the hardest of my trip. But it's still fun. I'm a strong banana.
He clearly is a strong banana. Look, he's so small climbing on the tall Himalayas. Gosh. And those villagers here, so they're like so confused. Is that a banana? No idea. Whoa, rainforest.
Dear Mango Boy, here I am, Amazon rainforest. Wow, the view from here is way different from where us lives. That's a grammar mistake, sorry. It's greeny and awesome, but there's only one problem. Monkey loves bananas. I should have known. Even though the monkeys tried to get me, I escaped by showing them I'm alive. So those dummies are scared.
That's a brave banana, so he was like so scared right here. Stop, no, stop, I'm alive. Monkey loves bananas, but monkey needs more bananas. Whoa, he ran straight into underwater, so this is supposed to be Pacific Ocean.
G'day, Pinky Cherry. How about going somewhere at the last few days before going to somewhere you couldn't imagine? Doing something good for the environment? That'd be cool, and a bit easy. There are many ways to help us living fruit planet, but I choose to die and snork to get rid of almost all of the plastic bottles and other trash under the sea. Isn't it cool?
Oh my god, I never imagined Mr. Banana to be an environmental activist. Oh gosh.
Look at the squid. Is this Davy Jones? Davy Jones demon. Gosh.
Yes. The last destination. Mars. Oh my god. That was cute.
Dear Mrs. Peach, have you ever thought of the red planet Mars? Or even travel there? It was surely hard for me to make my own space suit. And guess what? I'm from NASA. You're obsessed about punishing students if they don't want to learn about space. Guess now you longer want to punish me.
That's a funny banana. Hi, this looks exactly like the space suits from Martian. Because when I was in second grade and third grade, I was obsessed with Mars. Take a moment to appreciate this page.
Duh.
Duh.
Duh. That includes Jill's story of Mr. Banana's travels. And as we've mentioned, it's inspired by her second grade teacher, which have a toy called Mr. Banana, and also by the book called Monk. So yeah, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up if you like Mr. Banana, and also subscribe to our channel because, well, we're going to share a lot more stories coming up and other projects as well, so you won't want to miss out on that, don't you? Alright, without further ado, bye!